Welcome to the Dr. Izzy's Medical Podcast Channel.
Hodgkin lymphoma. Hodgkin lymphoma is a type of lymphoma, in which cancer originates from a specific type of white blood cells called lymphocytes, where multinucleated Reed-Sternberg cells are present in the patient's lymph nodes. Symptoms may include fever, night sweats, and weight loss. Often, non-painful enlarged lymph nodes occur in the neck, under the arm, or in the groin. Those affected may feel tired or be itchy. The two major types of Hodgkin lymphoma are classic Hodgkin lymphoma and nodular lymphocyte predominant Hodgkin lymphoma. About half of cases of Hodgkin lymphoma are due to Epstein-Barr virus, and these are generally the classic form. Other risk factors include a family history of the condition and having HIV/AIDS. Diagnosis is conducted by confirming the presence of cancer and identifying Reed-Sternberg cells in lymph node biopsies. The virus-positive cases are classified as a form of the Epstein-Barr virus-associated lymphoproliferative diseases. Hodgkin lymphoma may be treated with chemotherapy, radiation therapy, and stem cell transplant. The choice of treatment often depends on how advanced the cancer has become and whether or not it has favorable features. In early disease, a cure is often possible. In the United States, 88% of people diagnosed with Hodgkin lymphoma survive for 5 years or longer. For those under the age of 20, rates of survival are 97%. Radiation and some chemotherapy drugs, however, increase the risk of other cancers, heart disease, or lung disease over the subsequent decades. Signs and symptoms. People with Hodgkin lymphoma may present with the following symptoms. Lymphadenopathy, the most common symptom of Hodgkin, is the painless enlargement of one or more lymph nodes. The nodes may also feel rubbery and swollen when examined. The nodes of the neck, cervical and supraclavicular are most frequently involved. The lymph nodes of the chest are often affected, and these may be noticed on a chest radiograph. Systemic symptoms: about one-third of people with Hodgkin disease may also present with systemic symptoms, including itchy skin, night sweats, unexplained weight loss of at least 10% of the person's total body mass in 6 months or less, low-grade fever, fatigue, lassitude. Systemic symptoms such as fever, night sweats, and weight loss are known as B symptoms. Thus, presence of these indicate that the person's stage is, for example, 2B instead of 2A. Splenomegaly, enlargement of the spleen is often present in people with Hodgkin lymphoma. The enlargement, however, is seldom massive, and the size of the spleen may fluctuate during the course of treatment. Hepatomegaly, enlargement of the liver, due to liver involvement, is infrequent in people with Hodgkin lymphoma. Hepatosplenomegaly, the enlargement of both the liver and spleen caused by the same disease. Pain following alcohol consumption. Classically, involved nodes are painful after alcohol consumption, though this phenomenon is very uncommon, occurring in only 2-3% of people with Hodgkin lymphoma, thus having a low sensitivity. On the other hand, its positive predictive value is high enough for it to be regarded as a pathognomonic sign of Hodgkin lymphoma. The pain typically has an onset within minutes after ingesting alcohol, and is usually felt as coming from the vicinity where there is an involved lymph node. The pain has been described as either sharp and stabbing or dull and aching. Back pain, nonspecific back pain has been reported in some cases of Hodgkin lymphoma. The lower back is most often affected. Cyclical fever, people may also present with a cyclical high-grade fever known as the Pell-Epstein fever, or more simply PE fever. However, there is debate as to whether the PE fever truly exists. Nephrotic syndrome can occur in individuals with Hodgkin lymphoma and is most commonly caused by minimal change disease. May present with airway obstruction, pleural pericardial effusion, hepatocellular dysfunction, bone marrow infiltration. Diagnosis. Hodgkin lymphoma must be distinguished from non-cancerous causes of lymph node swelling and from other types of cancer. Definitive diagnosis is by lymph node biopsy, usually excisional biopsy with microscopic examination. Blood tests are also performed to assess function of major organs and to assess safety for chemotherapy. Positron emission tomography, which is PET, is used to detect small deposits that do not show on CT scanning. PET scans are also useful in functional imaging, by using a radiolabeled glucose to image tissues of high metabolism. In some cases, a gallium scan may be used instead of a PET scan. Types. There are two main types of Hodgkin lymphoma: classic Hodgkin lymphoma and nodular lymphocyte predominant Hodgkin lymphoma. The prevalence of classic Hodgkin lymphoma and nodular lymphocyte Hodgkin lymphoma are approximately 90% and 10%, respectively. The morphology, phenotype, molecular features, and, therefore, the clinical behavior and presentation of the two types differ. Classic type. Classic Hodgkin lymphoma, excluding nodular lymphocyte-predominant Hodgkin lymphoma, can be subclassified into four pathologic subtypes based upon Reed-Sternberg cell morphology and the composition of the reactive cell infiltrate seen in the lymph node biopsy specimen. The cell composition around the Reed-Sternberg cells. For the other forms, although the traditional B-cell markers, such as CD20, are not expressed on all cells, Reed-Sternberg cells are usually of B-cell origin. Although Hodgkin's is now frequently grouped with other B-cell malignancies, some T-cell markers, such as CD2 and CD4, are occasionally expressed. However, this may be an artifact of the ambiguity inherent in the diagnosis. Hodgkin cells produce interleukin-21, which was once thought to be exclusive to T cells. This feature may explain the behavior of classic Hodgkin lymphoma, including clusters of other immune cells gathered around HL cells in cultures. Nodular lymphocyte predominant. Nodular lymphocyte predominant Hodgkin lymphoma is another subtype of Hodgkin lymphoma distinct from classic Hodgkin lymphoma and is characterized by the presence of popcorn cells which express CD20. Due to these differences, among others, nodular lymphocyte predominant Hodgkin lymphoma is often treated differently from classic Hodgkin lymphoma, including using rituximab in combination with AVBD chemotherapy, though individual cases vary and clinical trials are ongoing. Staging. The staging is the same for both Hodgkin and non-Hodgkin lymphomas. After Hodgkin lymphoma is diagnosed, a person will be staged, that is, they will undergo a series of tests and procedures that will determine what areas of the body are affected. These procedures may include documentation of their histology, a physical examination, blood tests, chest X-ray radiographs, computed tomography, CT, positron emission tomography, PET, magnetic resonance imaging, MRI, scans of the chest, abdomen and pelvis, and usually a bone marrow biopsy. Positron emission tomography, PET, scan is now used instead of the gallium scan for staging. On the PET scan, sites involved with lymphoma light up very brightly, enabling accurate and reproducible imaging. In the past, a lymphangiogram or surgical laparotomy were performed. Lymphangiograms or laparotomies are very rarely performed, having been supplanted by improvements in imaging with the CT scan and PET scan. On the basis of this staging, the person will be classified according to a staging classification. The Ann Arbor staging classification scheme is a common one. Stage 1 is involvement of a single lymph node region, mostly the cervical region, or single extralymphatic site. Stage 2 is involvement of two or more lymph node regions on the same side of the diaphragm or of one lymph node region and contiguous extralymphatic site. Stage 3 is involvement of lymph node regions on both sides of the diaphragm, which may include the spleen or limited contiguous extralymphatic organ or site. Stage 4 is disseminated involvement of one or more extralymphatic organs. The absence of systemic symptoms is signified by adding A to the stage. The presence of systemic symptoms is signified by adding B to the stage. For localized extranodal extension for massive nodes that does not advance the stage, subscript E is added. Splenic involvement is signified by adding S to the stage. The inclusion of bulky disease is signified by X. Management of Hodgkin lymphoma. The current approach for treatment aims to reduce the acute and long-term toxicities associated with Hodgkin lymphoma, for example cardiac damage and secondary cancers, and increase overall survival. People with early stage disease, 1A or 2A, are effectively treated with radiation therapy or chemotherapy. The choice of treatment depends on the age, sex, bulk, and the histological subtype of the disease. Adding localized radiation therapy after the chemotherapy regimen may provide a longer progression-free survival compared with chemotherapy treatment alone. People with later disease, 3, 4A or 4B, are treated with combination chemotherapy alone. People of any stage with a large mass in the chest are usually treated with combined chemotherapy and radiation therapy. MOP. MOP is a combination chemotherapy regimen used to treat Hodgkin lymphoma. The acronym is derived from the component drugs of the regimen. M. Mustergen. O. Oncovin. P. Procarbazine. P. Prednisone. The original treatment for Hodgkin's was MOP. The abbreviation stands for the four drugs: mustergen, also known as chlormethine; oncovin, also known as vincristine; prednisone; and procarbazine, also known as matulane. The treatment is usually administered in 4-week cycles, often for 6 cycles. MSD and VCR are administered intravenously, while procarbazine and prednisone are pills taken orally. MOP was the first combination chemotherapy brought in that achieved a high success rate. It was developed at the National Cancer Institute in the 1960s by a team that included Vincent DeVita Jr. Although no longer the most effective combination, MOP is still used after relapse or where the person has certain allergies or lung or heart problems which prevents the use of another regimen. ABVD. ABVD is a chemotherapy regimen used in the first-line treatment of Hodgkin lymphoma, replacing the older MOP protocol. It consists of concurrent treatment with the chemotherapy drugs. Adriamycin, also known as doxorubicin hydroxidon or ribicin, designated as HNC-HOP. Bleomycin. Vinblastine. Dacarbazine, similar to procarbazine, designated as PN-MOP and NCOP. Currently, the ABVD chemotherapy regimen is the standard treatment of Hodgkin's disease in the U.S. The abbreviation stands for the four drugs adriamycin, bleomycin, vinblastine, and dacarbazine. Developed in Italy in the 1970s, the ABVD treatment typically takes between 6 and 8 months, although longer treatments may be required. Stanford 5. Stanford 5 is a chemotherapy regimen, with accompanying radiation therapy, intended as a first-line treatment for Hodgkin lymphoma. The regimen was developed in 1988, with the objective of maintaining a high remission rate while reducing the incidence of acute and long-term toxicity, pulmonary damage, and sterility observed in alternative treatment regimens such as ABVD. The chemical agents used are a mustard derivative such as cyclophosphamide, chloramethine or ifosfamide, doxorubicin, an anti-tumor antibiotic, vinblastine, an alkaloid cell toxin, vincristine, another alkaloid cell toxin, bleomycin, another anti-tumor antibiotic, etoposide, a DNA toxin, prednisone, a corticosteroid, BCOP. BCOP is a form of treatment for stages greater than 2, mainly used in Europe. The cure rate with the BCOP regimen is approximately 10 to 15% higher than with standard ABVD in advanced stages. This was shown in a paper in the New England Journal of Medicine, but U.S. physicians still favor ABVD, maybe because some physicians think that BCOP induces more secondary leukemia. However, this seems negligible compared to the higher cure rates. BCOP is more expensive because of the requirement for concurrent treatment with G-CSF to increase production of white blood cells. BCOP includes doxorubicin, bleomycin, vincristine, cyclophosphamide, procarbazine, etoposide, prednisone. The common non-Hodgkin treatment, rituximab, which is a monoclonal antibody against CD20, is not routinely used to treat Hodgkin lymphoma due to the lack of CD20 surface antigens in most cases. The use of rituximab in Hodgkin lymphoma, including the lymphocyte-predominant subtype, has been recently reviewed. The evidence is very uncertain about the effect of nivolumab for patients with a Hodgkin's lymphoma, for example, on the overall survival. Although increased age is an adverse risk factor for Hodgkin lymphoma, in general elderly people without major comorbidities are sufficiently fit to tolerate standard therapy, and have a treatment outcome comparable to that of younger people. However, the disease is a different entity and older people and different considerations enter into treatment decisions. For Hodgkin lymphomas, radiation oncologists typically use external beam radiation therapy, sometimes shortened to EBRT or XRT. Radiation oncologists deliver external beam radiation therapy to the lymphoma from a machine called a linear accelerator, which produces high-energy X-rays and electrons. People usually describe treatments as painless and similar to getting an X-ray. Treatments last less than 30 minutes each. For lymphomas, there are a few different ways radiation oncologists target the cancer cells. Involved site radiation is when the radiation oncologists give radiation only to those parts of the person's body known to have the cancer. Very often, this is combined with chemotherapy. Radiation therapy directed above the diaphragm to the neck, chest or underarms is called mantle field radiation. Radiation to below the diaphragm to the abdomen, spleen or pelvis is called inverted Y-field radiation. Total nodal irradiation is when the therapist gives radiation to all the lymph nodes in the body to destroy cells that may have spread. Adverse effects. The high cure rates and long survival of many people with Hodgkin lymphoma has led to a high concern with late adverse effects of treatment, including cardiovascular disease and second malignancies such as acute leukemias, lymphomas, and solid tumors within the radiation therapy field. Most people with early stage disease are now treated with abbreviated chemotherapy and involve site radiation therapy rather than with radiation therapy alone. Clinical research strategies are exploring reduction of the duration of chemotherapy and dose and volume of radiation therapy in an attempt to reduce late morbidity and mortality of treatment while maintaining high cure rates. Hospitals are also treating those who respond quickly to chemotherapy with no radiation. In childhood cases of Hodgkin lymphoma, long-term endocrine adverse effects are a major concern, mainly gonadal dysfunction and growth retardation. Gonadal dysfunction seems to be the most severe endocrine long-term effect, especially after treatment with alkylating agents or pelvic radiotherapy. It is possible that patients undergoing a chemotherapy need a platelet transfusion. If a stem cell transplantation is necessary for the treatment of a relapse, graft versus host diseases might occur. Supportive treatment. Adding physical exercises to the standard treatment for adult patients with hematological malignancies like Hodgkin lymphoma may result in little to no difference in the mortality, the quality of life and the physical functioning. These exercises may result in a slight reduction in depression. Furthermore, aerobic physical exercises probably reduce fatigue. The evidence is very uncertain about the effect on anxiety and serious adverse events.
Thank you for listening to Dr. Izzy's Medical Podcast Series. If you want to support this project, please subscribe the channel and like this video. Thank you.